lots of breeding stuff today. Truth be told, we filmed this intro and my mic had messed up. So this is after the video had been taken. But you want to stay for the end because there's going to be a whole lot of foal cuteness, a whole lot of amazing videography of the babies running around in the field. So that's at the end. And then the rest of it is just going to be breeding. So we are preg checking Erlene. We are going to be checking quite a few different mares to see where they're at in their cycle, whether that be for us to breed them for their own babies or to have embryos put into them. But let's just get into it. But you need to do it by 6.5 days to be frozen. So sometimes that can lower your chances of finding the embryo. She's also got like a gigantic uterus, and we noticed there was issues with the flushing process with her cysts. Cysts don't usually cause an issue if they are being bred to carry themselves, but since we're trying to flush her, we went ahead and did a procedure to laser those cysts off. It should make it a lot more smoother process now. She had some downtime, and now we are back into trying to see where she's at in her cycle to see if she can be bred again.
You can actually see the cyst kind of sucking into the tube.
Uh-huh. So she is in heat right now. Let's see what kind of follicles she's got. Oh my gosh.
Big one.
We got time to even.
It's a big one.
Do we got time to even get semen here tomorrow, or?
Yeah, freeze that.
Or should we do it today? Let's guess what size this is. I think it's gonna be like a 4 or 5. Maybe even a 5.
5'2".
5'2", you say? How big is she?
45.
4 or 5. So why don't we plan on that since I have his semen on hand?
Okay.
Just so we don't miss it.
Well, you want to flush her again?
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is what would happen. You'd give her a shot Wednesday night, which is tonight. She'd ovulate Friday morning. Today's Thursday. She'd ovulate Saturday morning. So we would flush her at 6.5 days. But since it's frozen, day 6.5 is right on the weekend. So you're right back in the same situation.
So do you try to, if I bring her to you, do you monitor her and see if you can do it as late as possible, or?
Yeah, not with the frozen.
No?
No, I'd like to time it up with an ovulation shot. Otherwise, you have to have her checked every 6 hours for days. With a shot, you can lock in that window.
What do you think is the best option with it being frozen and shipping it? Like, what do you think our timing option is?
Skip this cycle.
Skip it completely?
Yeah, and do it during the week. Short cycler where she's doing it during the week. Or don't freeze it. Find somewhere to put the embryo and
We have to freeze it because we're biopsying it.
Or ship her and let them flush her there and let somebody in Dallas flush her. Where's it going to get biopsied?
Equi-embryo in Texas.
Breed her and ship her and let somebody flush her. Based on their schedule at that location.
That's adding a whole lot of dollars.
Yeah.
Yeah. And just like stress on her. Okay.
Well, why don't you do this? We know what she's got. Call Equi-embryo while we're checking these mares and see what the timing is. Loop Heather in and see what logistics are. Because if she does right, we would have to flush her on Saturday morning. It'd be the same scenario. The only difference is she doesn't have a cyst, so the flush would be better. But it'd be half a day early, which is a very, very small
right.
embryo.
Right, right.
It's just, yeah. Just lowering your chances of retrieval.
Well, half a day early to be frozen or half a day early because of the timing?
Because of the timing. You're already a day early. To freeze, you need to flush at 6.5.
Right.
To just transfer fresh, we're flushing at 7.5.
Right.
So it's easier to find. So logistics, we drop from 6.5 back to 6 or 5.5. If there's some delay.
Right.
And the embryo didn't even drop out of the fallopian tube till day 5.5. So you're playing with like a 12-hour window.
Okay.
And it may not be a bad idea anyway because she just got laser just to let her go through a cycle.
Okay. We can do that.
And she looks good. There's no cyst.
Awesome. Okay, so would you give her a shot today then to just get her out of heat?
Yeah, we could do that.
Okay, my plans just didn't work out. I was like, we'll just breed Sophie today, and then we'll just flush her, and I'll be good. But when you're flushing a mare and you're freezing it, come here, Matthew. And we're shipping it to Texas, and they have office hours and things like that. It does get tricky when it falls on a weekend. It would fall on a weekend if we bred her this time. And so we decided, since she's like right there ready to ovulate, we are going to let her go out of this cycle. She'd already had a procedure to laser some cysts off, and she's had that time period of rest, but it doesn't hurt to like let her have more time. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna short cycle her, give her luteolize probably next week, and then try to time her ovulation for like middle of the week for shipping purposes, logistics purposes, all those things.
Freeze that.
Oh my goodness. She's got a big one too.
She had a 4 or 5 on the right.
Yeah. Well, she went in heat, right?
So she had a big follicle last week, but she wasn't in really good heat and didn't have a whole lot of edema. Does she look better this week?
She has the same follicle. I need to look at her uterus. I don't think she's in heat again either.
It's a 4-0. It went down.
Cysts and beautiful. No edema. What's that? Did she have a CL somewhere, Rachel?
CL on the left.
Nate, I need you to find this left ovary. It is MIA.
I think you need to go down just a little.
Oh, down to the left.
Down thanks. To the left, just a little.
Thanks. What are you feeling in there?
CL.
That's a little one's.
CL. Same thing. CL
you
on the left.
At the University of Tennessee.
So basically, she's the same as she was last time. Not a whole lot of edema, not in super good heat, and she's just got that one big old follicle. So are we just going to kind of keep tabs on her?
Well, like I said, I don't like to give a luteolize shot with that sitting around because you...
Yeah.
Or you can give it, and if she ovulates that one, we're not breeding on it. But if she regresses that one and builds another one, we can breed on that one.
What do you think, like, best chance? Just kind of keep watching her since you're coming out kind of quite often right now?
Yeah.
Okay.
Will you text Heather and tell her to arrange embryo shipment, or will you arrange embryo shipment on Monday?
Yes.
So we don't drop the ball on that.
Okay. So those last two, Annie, we're just going to have to just kind of keep watching her because she's got this huge follicle, but like no edema. She's not in heat. So we've got to wait for all of the pieces to be together before we can breed her and have success. And then Phoebe, she ovulated what looks like this morning. So that times out 4 days from now to put a frozen embryo in on Monday. And that will be a full sibling to Kirby.
When things are in heat and they're soft, their cervix is really flaccid. No, uterus is real flaccid. When they have tone, they have a lot of progesterone, so it's more
firm.
Firm, exactly. Less flaccid. So that's your bladder.
She did have a super full bladder last time. What is that?
A vessel. Did you see it? As it stays the same as I move side to side. If it was just a blip on the radar, it could be a little vesicle.
He's upset.
So here's the right ovary.
That's she's a got small, some follicles.
Small follicles.
Am I correct in saying the follicle is almost like a little fluid sac around the oocyte?
Mm-hmm, exactly. Yep. And see, she still has good cervical tone. She's not in heat.
A lot of people ask me what a follicle is, and it's basically like a little fluid-filled sac that surrounds the oocyte, basically the egg. And so we're seeing which one is most mature, and that's the egg that turns into an embryo when met with sperm. That's kind of funny that you're just a horse OB, and your dad's an OB.
The only thing I knew when I went to college that I didn't want to do was be a doctor.
That's a good podcast. Talk about their stories from every day.
Is there the same kind of like HIPAA laws with animals as there is humans?
Yeah. Just not as tightly regulated and watched. But yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do you want to give her loot now?
Yeah, what I was thinking is give her loot and check her on Monday.
Okay, we can do it.
Who are we breeding her to?
Making me really wild. Okay. And so it's fresh semen.
Yeah, let's check her on Monday. Let's... Erlene doesn't need sedation.
Yes, she does.
She does need sedation. Can we put some water in there for me? In that sink, in that. This one's going to be tiny because it's a 14-day frozen, so it should be about a 13-day.
Oh, okay. So should we have waited?
No, I mean, we should be able to see it.
Do you know what side she was bred on?
I'd have to look back at her palpation. Like right there, you see that? Grasping for straws, but I thought I saw something that looked like a 11-dayer.
Could that even be possible?
Oh, yeah. I mean, these frozens, they take, on average, a day longer to mature. So, like when you're doing embryos, you flush them at day 8.5 instead of 7.5. So.
Okay. Is that something to think about with Sophie? I mean, I think we already gave her her shot, but.
Yeah, I mean, would be the same thing. You know?
Okay.
But you see that right there?
Yeah.
I think it's too small to be one, but we need to recheck her. I think it would be more obvious if she was.
So we're not seeing much, but with her being bred with frozen semen, they do mature a little bit later. So we are going to check her again on Monday before we rule her out on being pregnant. Last year, my breeding season was like, bam, 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 everybody pregnant. This year, it's just not like that. But I think I would take the less dramatic foaling season over the less dramatic breeding season. I think I will choose that every time. I will work harder during breeding season if I can ensure a very low drama foaling season.
Has Denver gotten a lot of pregnancies with this frozen?
I'm not quite sure. I mean, we have one, but that was with a frozen embryo. And I got like multiple off of doing ICSI, but I'm not quite sure.
Was there a lot of frozen semen before you bought them?
No. Okay, so we're not going to rule out Erlene being pregnant, okay? We're going to hold out hope that it was just a little too early. Last thing we are doing, Happy is our last mare of the year, two foal. She's at day 321. She is starting to get a little wax in her teats, looking very uncomfortable, all the things. So while he's out, we're going to put a foal alert in and then keep a very close eye. Whoa, sweetie. Maybe a little bit. She like makes me flinch. It's very cloudy. It's not white though. I'm thinking this weekend, but we'll see. It's still green. It's still at 7. It's a strong 7. So we need her down here to be like, it's happening.
On Monday, I'll be back in the afternoon, if that's okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're about to go get Maggie.
Okay.
Hopefully we get there before them. This breeding season, man, it ain't going the way I hope it would. But, you know, like I said earlier, I would take
a
dramatic hard breeding season over a dramatic hard foaling season any day. So I do not mind working harder and double breeding if I have to get the pregnancies if they all come out with happy little babies. So lots of things to check next week, lots of planning, lots of crossing our fingers, praying, hoping. Let me know if you have any questions, and you're gonna be watching some really cute foals for the rest of this video with some really cute music, honestly. Maybe some violin, maybe some fiddle, like some country, like slow, elegant music. They don't know anything about this. I'm just throwing this out there. So hope y'all enjoy.